Hello and welcome back to my channel here on YouTube. My name is Dr. Marcus Mehta and I hope on this channel I bring you an insight into what it's like to own some vehicles that I think are quite special to own. So with me, I've got my 2007 Land Rover Defender TD5 and I've owned this car for about a year now. I'm going to be telling you in this video what it's been like for that year that I've owned it. I've covered around 1,000 miles, so what's been great, what I've loved about this car, but also what's gone wrong and things I haven't quite liked as much as maybe I thought I would when I bought this car. So let's go for a drive. You will know to watch this channel regularly, I am a cosmetic doctor and have nothing to do with cars. However, I do love cars, and ever since I was young, this car has been a car I've always wanted to own. There's nothing that looks quite like a Defender, that drives quite like a Defender, which is for good and bad reasons we'll get onto later in this video. And so for me, the iconic Land Rover Defender is a car that I've always wanted to have in my garage. And it was about a year ago that I went ahead and bought this car. So in that year, I've covered around 1,000 miles in it. So I've got a reasonable experience of what the car's like, what it's been particularly good at, and also what it's been not so great at as well. So when I bought this car, it was a private seller down in Oxford. I went and picked it up and it was, you know, all went well. There was no issues with it at all. I took it for a service when I got the car because I think it's always good just to get all the oils replaced and just kind of get it a once-over really by a specialist garage that just deals with Defenders. So when I did that, they found that you know, it was actually pretty good underneath. The chassis was good, there was no corrosion or rot, which actually is one of the biggest problems with these cars. They do rust badly, and although you can see surface rust on the underneath of the cars, it's more that rust which is corrosive, and actually you can put a screwdriver through, that you want to avoid if you are looking at buying one of these. The other thing they found was the brake pipes were slightly corroded at the front, and you can see this, so you can actually check if you are looking at buying. You can actually look over the wheel and see the little brake pipes and see where they are rusted and corroded. They needed doing, you know, and that was, I accepted that, you know, it's over 10 years old, this car, so I thought, yeah, fine, we did the brake pipes, not a problem at all. To be honest, since that, the miles that I've done in it and where I've been in it, it's been absolutely brilliant. I've absolutely loved the whole ownership of this car. It's like I say, it's one of those very unique cars on the road. There's nothing really quite like it. So the new one certainly isn't anything like this car from a comfort point of view. My other car's a Discovery 5, and with that, you really, it's a whole different world being in this car. You really feel like you're driving in this car. But yeah, the ownership for me has been fantastic. I've loved every element of it, and I would definitely recommend buying one if that's what you're interested in and you're thinking a Defender might be a car for you. However, with Defenders, as much as they are good from an emotional point of view and as much as they've got such a huge following, they arguably are one of the worst cars on the road to drive. They're bumpy, they're noisy, they're cold. Everything you touch in this cabin is either it's squished up, or it's very, very hot, or it's very, very cold, or you've got the sharp aluminium body panel sticking into you somewhere. So from that point of view, that's not been great. You know, there's definitely an element of it not being a car you'd probably want to use as an everyday car. But if you want a car that's for more times when you don't need to be in a rush to go somewhere, you're not doing a long journey, then this is a car I would always pick. One of the things I've also loved about owning this car is the ability to modify it. There's so many things you can do to Defenders to bring them back to where they were when they were bought brand new, but also to customize them in a way that suits you. There's so many different looks, from a very heritage look to much more of a new age, all black sort of Chelsea tractor type look that you can do with these Defenders. So for me, the element of being able to do stuff, and not only that, but actually do a lot of it yourself. They're really simple to work with, and particularly in lockdown. I don't know, we're in lockdown 3 or 4 at the moment, but during the whole period of the last year or so, it's been a great project to work on and slowly bring things back on this car to where they were, and make it look the way I wanted it to look, really. So for me, the element of customization for these cars is amazing. There's so much available online, there's so much support, and they're actually pretty easy to work with. They're basically just big Meccano sets. Now, as I've mentioned, there is a lot of downsides to owning a Defender, and I'm going to talk about them now. So the first thing is how cold they are. Now, the cold can also be combined with the noisiness. Now, these cars rattle, as you can probably hear in the back now, so much when you're driving them. There's so much sound deadening and soundproofing you need to do in these cars to actually get them to a point where they're comfortable to drive in. So for me, the hollowness, the rattling, and the coldness of these cars, particularly in winter like it is now, you know, it takes probably around 30, 40 minutes to get warm enough to drive and be comfortable in. The next thing is a leak. So these cars do leak, and they leak through the fronts generally. So where the windscreen seal is, they erode over time and you get water ingress through there. But the other place you get it from is in the bulkhead where you have the vents. So this car still has a little push-pull vent to bring airflow into the car, which is great in summertime because they also get really hot as well, but they're also a place where water likes to come through. And there's a few things you can do to that to make it a bit more comfortable. So you can change some of the rubber seals to try and stop some of the water coming in. But it's a real challenge to find exactly where that is. But you do know if it rains heavy, you're going to end up with wet feet and water pooling in your footwell, which is not ideal if you're going anywhere that you need to wear shoes. One of the notable things with this model, which is a TD5, is as much as they're loved by Land Rover enthusiasts and were the engine that was built in-house in Solihull by Land Rover before they went to the Ford Puma engine or the Ford Transit van engine in 2007, just after this car was made, is these cars aren't very good at going long distances, particularly the TD5. You've got a 5-speed gearbox in this, and that means that when you get to about 50 to 60 miles per hour, that's pretty much as fast as you want to be going. I haven't actually driven a Puma, so the model above this, the next series, but I understand they're a lot better at cruising at faster speeds and are a bit more comfortable on motorway driving. This definitely isn't a motorway driving car. So when I picked this car up in Oxford, I had around a 3-hour trip home to get it back to where I live, and it was really not a comfortable drive. On short trips, these cars are great fun and, you know, nice just to sort of cruise around in, but they're definitely not a car you want to be going anywhere far in or going on the motorway or anything like that. And that brings me on to my next point about these cars, which is safety. So you may think, and I definitely did think, that Defenders are really safe cars. You know, they're really heavy, full solid metal kind of build cars. But actually, when you do a lot of reading about these cars, and I did this because I was actually going to put Isofix in the back of this car and carry my children in it, and I was reading about the safety elements of a Defender, because for some reason, at one time, I was going to have this 90 and also get a 110 as a family car, which is definitely not a good idea, and I soon got talked out of that. But I think for me, safety was something I did look into, and when I'm by myself, it's not something that bothers me too much. When you're carrying passengers and children and things, you want to be a bit more careful. And what you find is these cars are brilliant and solid in their chassis, but they have no crumple zones, and more importantly, the actual body on these cars is just sheet aluminium. And I've found that out myself when I've cut these back windows in. It's like, you know, it's four millimeter aluminium and that's it. It's like a big tin shell. And I've seen some horrible videos that I looked up at the time. When these cars roll or flip, they completely crumble. So a lot of people actually go for an external roll cage, which is a really nice addition. It actually looks quite good as well. They're quite expensive. They're around the kind of £1,500 to £2,000 mark, but they really improve the safety of this car massively by adding an external shell to it. So if you look at Defenders from that point of view, from a safety element, they're not brilliant. Probably at low speeds, they're fine, you're sitting high up, but you would not want to be getting hit by anything in this car at a higher speed, or you certainly wouldn't want to be rolling it. Now, one of the most worrying elements of owning this car, and one of the things that bothers me the most probably, is the fact that these cars are so stolen. I'm on a lot of groups online of stolen Land Rovers, and every single day there's a post around a Defender being stolen, particularly at the moment. And it makes it quite uncomfortable owning this car in a way, because you really don't feel comfortable leaving it anywhere. You wouldn't want to be leaving it in a train station car park. You wouldn't want to leave it anywhere really for too long overnight at all without loads of security on it. And even then, these cars get stolen. There's been quite a few recently that have been stolen by low loader and people towing them onto the back of a truck. And you can't really stop that regardless of how many steering locks or pedal locks you've got on your car. So for me, having owned this car, it's probably one of the most stressful elements is how I look after its safety. And it's remarkable, really, because these cars are, as I mentioned, awful to drive and own in a way, but they're also one of the highest, most stolen, because the parts can be stripped off them so well. So there's one other thing, which is, you've probably read about when you look at Defenders, is driving position. Driving position in these cars is great in the sense that you're sat high up and you can see the whole bonnet and you kind of feel you're in an authoritative position on the road. But the problem with it is you are so close to this door, and the standard steering wheels on these are comically large. They're huge, and you can't really drive the car with them, to be honest, if you're going around corners. So for me, having a smaller wheel helps, but also, to be honest, having the window open helps, because you can actually put your arm out the window, which makes a massive difference to your comfort when you're sat here driving. So, I hope that's been interesting to find out a bit more about what my ownership journey's been like having this car. I have all the plans to keep this car for a long time, unless something else might tempt me to change. If you have any ideas about what other car I could change to, or might be good to have on the channel, let me know in the comments below. So drop us a comment below, like this video, and I'll see what you guys are saying about what maybe we could go for next. If you are looking at buying a Defender, or you have any questions about, you know, what to look for, I do have, I did a buying guide to this car on my channel too, which you can see the link to the video right here. But please feel free to comment in the chat box below. I really appreciate all the support, and I shall see you guys soon.